Toby Hooper died with his reputation in tatters. Fans and critics alike convinced that he, like Orson Welles before him, had only made one masterpiece and had frittered away his chances. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre is one of the most important and vital works of American art, a countercultural nightmare, the death of an invented, protesting innocence. Hooper spent his life documenting the end of innocence. Producers refused to take chances on him, even though he made some of the most staggeringly beautiful genre films of all time. In his world, America was a vampire, draining her people of their ideals. Hooper's earnest Texan psychedelia and his cinephilia helped him create one of the most beautifully devastating canons in the American cinema, a country fried Max Ophuls. He was the Blue Cheer or Black Sabbath of horror cinema, taking the foundational grammar of the masters who'd preceded him and warping the sound until he'd made it his own through sheer force of personality. H.P. Lovecraft, Flannery O'Connor, and William Faulkner, he saw that there was something sinister buried in the American character. That evil burrowed inside us. His first fiction feature, Eggshells, showed a commune in Texas slowly falling apart, while a malevolent force gained power in the earth below them. A metaphor for America's genocidal past, present, and future. Outside, the Vietnam War raged on, and protests spill into the street. History sits like a pestilence in the soil waiting to be dug up or disturbed. The hermetic, Christian, white, industrial class feed on the blood of the idealistic because the government has abandoned them to their own devices. It's a dog-eat-dog world. Hooper fell victim to it as well when he had his second greatest financial success, Poltergeist, taken from him in the public consciousness. Like Welles and the Magnificent Ambersons, he'd never recover from having his legacy questioned. It's perversely fitting that his greatest failure is about the very machinery of capitalism that would imprison him in the world of low-budget productions. The Mangler tanked. No critic stood up for it, and it preceded Hooper working for nearly a decade in TV or straight-to-video horror movies. It's a joke to most people who never saw Hooper as an artist. It only makes sense that Hooper shouldn't be treated as an auteur if the Texas Chainsaw Massacre is a fluke, and the idea that a film that precise is uncharacteristic of a career this rich is insulting. The Mangler concerns a laundry press literally feeding off the blood of a miserable lower class living in the shadow of a nearly mechanical man in charge of the bleak factory where the cursed machine rests.
Chaos abounds, my dear. You'd better get used to it. Like I told you, there's no free lunch, no sirree, Bob.
Hooper continues his use of metaphorical machinery swallowing the innocent in eggshells.
Thank you.
typically and marvelously for a filmmaker so attuned to the integral role played by production design and art direction, the Mangler's villain is a piece of the set. It's a gorgeously crafted center for a work whose driving purpose is old-school filmmaking, luxurious tracking shots, flamboyant design elements, and performances big enough to fit the grim fairy tale nature of the story.
Well, it is what it is, right?
Johnny, don't. I mean, you
what?
Can't.
A woman's dead, Mark. It folded her like a sheep.
It's gorgeously overwrought and extends every limb towards cinephile touchstones, even if it's hiding in the body of a cheap Stephen King adaptation. The director of Texas Chainsaw Massacre had maybe lost a little of his budget and youthful zeal, but the man born in a movie house was still behind the wheel. The Mangler was a kind of oddball film with an unknowable center that had become a rarity in American cinema. That just makes it that much more special.
Thanks for coming and visiting me, Johnny. You made an old man very happy.
Toby Hooper may never find himself in the same posthumously exalted company as Orson Welles, but both men had an inherent knack for cinema's inner workings, knew its machinery with a lover's intimacy, and weren't afraid to show off their fearsome intelligence. Fate kept Hooper from accolade and recognition of his genius during his lifetime. Now that he's gone, we at least have a life's work that has gone unappreciated to finally sift through. And sift we must. This industry is hard on artists. The next Toby Hooper might not have the original's resilience and strength.